Now let's talk about modeling categorical variables with three or more groups. This happens many times. The researcher must model a categorical variable that has more than two groups. And in order to include all of this information in a multiple regression analysis, you have to create dummy variables. Again, there are a couple other ways to do this type of modeling, but we're going to focus on dummy variables here. There's always going to be one less dummy variable than there are groups. So if we think back to the earlier example with dichotomous variables like gender, there's two groups. That's what dichotomous means, male and female. So there's always going to be one less variables than groups. So if there's two groups, there's one variable. And that's why we didn't have to do any work to adjust that variable for our analysis. You're either male or female. You have a 0 or 1 on that one variable, and whether you have a zero or 1 tells us all that we need to know. But let's suppose the situation were a little more complicated. Maybe we're talking about ethnicity, and we have five groups, white, black, Hispanic, Asian, and perhaps mixed ethnicity. Right? So if we have five different groups, we need more than one dummy variable in order for it to work in a regression equation. Again, we're only going to have zeros and ones. So if we had only one variable, we could only distinguish between two groups, and that's not going to work. So 5 minus 1 is 4. We'll need four dummy variables in order to model these five groups. So suppose you are interested in predicting parental attachment. That's your dependent variable in adult college students. Okay. So you suspect, and maybe there's some other predictors that you're interested in, but in the process of doing your research, you determine that you think that students' parental attachment dynamics are going to differ by ethnic group. Right? So ethnic group would be an independent variable. Parental attachment would be your dependent variable. So you to include ethnicity as a demographic control variable in your model. So it may not be the variable that you're ultimately interested in, but you want to clean up some of that variation associated with ethnicity before you try to look at maybe some other more substantively meaningful variables. So you're starting off with, you'd be looking at ethnicity and parental attachment. So to begin, you might try making a box plot. And in your box plot, you have your predictor ethnicity on the x-axis. So now we have five different groups. Before, there was just male and female, so the graph was a little smaller. Now there's five different plots. On the y-axis is parental attachment. That's the dependent variable of interest. And so we can take a look at the medians. Remember, box plots give you the medians, not the means. So you can see the ranges and you can see the medians. We have a potential outlier over here and how they compare. This doesn't tell us about statistical significance, of course, but it gives us a good general idea. We have our white students, which range from the very bottom to the very top. Same thing with our black students. Asian Pacific Islanders, kind of a little bit narrow of a range. There's probably less of them in the sample, as I recall. Now we have our Hispanic students and our mixed ethnicity students, which appear to have higher medians and then higher minimum values. Right. So these three ethnic groups have roughly the same median. This is white, black, and Asian respondents. And then up here, we have our Hispanic and mixed ethnicity students, which appear to have roughly equal medians, which seem to be higher than these. So just looking at this box plot suggests to us that we might find significant between group differences on this dependent variable. Let's take a look at a table comparing the means. Right. So this table gives us, if you were to go to analyze means, compare means in SPSS, this is going to give you the mean for each of these ethnic groups on the parental attachment variable. So before we thought that the white, black, and Asian would have about the same median. Here we have white, black, Asian, negative 0.2, negative 0.5, negative 0.3, kind of in the same ballpark. All of them are below the overall group average, which is 0.02. And then our Hispanic and mixed ethnicity students appear to be higher, 0.6 and 0.5, reflected here. So these are the means, these are the medians, but they're going to be about the same when you have a normally distributed distribution. Okay, what else can we take a look at? Perhaps we should note, in my little table thing is telling me here, that this table doesn't tell us anything about statistical significance. So some people will like to look at this table and conclude that Hispanics have the highest amount of parental attachment. And that might be true in this sample, but we don't know if this is a statistically significant difference, right? We don't know. We have to determine that in our analysis, our inferential analysis. Okay, next we'll create a frequency table. So we can look at the percentages in each group. So we can see that the highest proportion of these respondents are white, right? 40 of them, or roughly, it's about 100 students, so roughly 40 or 40% are whites, about 30% Hispanic, and so forth. So unless we have a different theoretical reason for doing otherwise, we're gonna use white as our reference group for dummy coding purposes because it's the largest group. If we had 40% Hispanics and 30% white, we'd switch that around, probably use them as our reference group. Again, unless there was some other reason, but we won't go into that any further. Notice that there are not a lot of Asian or mixed ethnicity students. We have 5 and 6 respectively. It's about 5 and 6%. So we want to be really tentative about our conclusions regarding these groups. If we were to find that Asian students had the highest parental attachment, we'd want to be cautious about really trumpeting that finding since we're only talking about 4 Asian students. If we had even less than this, maybe 1 or 2 students, we might consider just removing them from our analysis altogether because we really couldn't model those differences. So here we can run this model, but we want to be tentative about our findings. In this case, we have 5 different ethnic groups. The white students are our reference group, and so we're always going to have 1 less dummy variables than we have total groups. That means we're going to have 4 dummy variables, 1 for each of these comparison groups. So each dummy variable will compare its respective group to the white reference group. So just with male and female, with the dichotomous variable, you're comparing the males to the female reference group. Here we would be comparing the Hispanic students with the white students, black students and white students, Asian students and white students, and mixed ethnicity students versus white students. So again, 4 new variables. The first variable will make this comparison. Second variable, black versus white. Third variable, Asian versus white. The final variable would be mixed students versus white. Okay. One thing you're going to want to do is make a note of how these groups have been coded in the data set. So to find out, you'd go, you click on the values box when you're in the variables view to see how they have been coded. In this case, it's set up in your data set. It's set up as a numeric variable versus a string variable, which would just have the words white, Hispanic, black. In this case, values have already been set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, each one corresponding to a particular group. So 1 equals white, 2 equals Hispanic, and so forth. So you want to keep this in mind when it comes time to recoding the variables. Again, we have 5 new dummy variables. And for each one of these, we're going to tell the computer whether each participant is in that group or not. So our first dummy variable will tell the computer whether the individual is Hispanic or not. If they are, they get a 1. If they're not, they get a 0. Next one tells the computer whether the participant is black or not, yes or no, 1 or 0, and so forth. So how do we create these new variables? It's a little bit of a process. What we have to do is use the option under transform, recode into different variables. When you click on that, it opens up this window right here. And so you have an old variable and a new variable. You're going to use information from an old variable to create a new variable. So the old variable is ethnicity, right? So this is our existing categorical variable that has these 5 levels. And we're going to create 4 new variables, Hispanic, Black, Asian, and mixed. Okay, my computer is going slow. There we go. So what we do is we tell it our old variable is ethnicity. The new variable will be Hispanic. So we've got to make 4. So we do this 4 different times. So the first time, we type in the word Hispanic right here. When you click change, it comes up going ethnicity arrow Hispanic. And then we click on old and new values to tell the computer what we're changing into what. So as you recall, Hispanics were numbered, had the number 2. So if the old value is 2, we're going to tell the computer to change the value to 1 in the new variable. So if they had a 2, they get a 1. We click add, and it comes up like this. 2 becomes 1. Everything else becomes 0. So this Hispanic variable is just supposed to tell the computer whether or not someone is Hispanic. So now it's dichotomous. You either are or you are not. So if you are, right, you used to have a 2, now you get a 1. If you are not, right here, all other values are 0. Add, it's going to come up and look like this. A 2 becomes 1, everything else becomes 0, and continue. And when you run that, you actually end up creating a new variable in your data set. So if it would be down here at the bottom of the list, these are the variables that were already there. Now this new one, Hispanic. What I did here is I moved it up the list, would be right next to ethnicity. That's why it's right here. On this list and this picture, and not in this picture, I moved it between here to put it side by side. And it's always a good idea to check in the data view to make sure it was coded correctly. Right? So we can go down the list here and see all the ethnicities: mixed, Hispanic, white, Hispanic, black, white, so forth. So every time you see Hispanic, you should see a 1. Right? So Hispanic 1, Hispanic 1, Hispanic 1. Everyone else, regardless of what their ethnicity is, should have a 0. Right? So mixed 0, white 0, black 0, white 0, black 0. Right? Everyone else should have a 0 because this variable is just telling us whether you are Hispanic or not. Okay? Now we have to repeat this process 3 more times because we need 4 dummy variables. Are you Hispanic or not? Are you black or not? Are you Asian or not? Are you of mixed ethnicity or not? So the same process, you have to change the output variable name in each case, black, Asian, mix. If you don't change that, it's going to record over the old variable and just make a huge mess in your data set. So I'll have a separate video walking you through that process. Please take your time and don't, that would override your earlier variable and you end up wasting effort that way and probably get confused. So the black students were previously labeled a 3, number 3. So in that case, 3 becomes 1, everyone else is 0. Asian, 4 becomes 1, everyone else is 0. Mixed ethnicity, 5 becomes 1, everyone else is a 0. So you have end up with 4 variables telling the computer whether they are that group or not. Again, there's no variable for white, that's the reference group. They just get zeros. Okay. So what I did here is I put all 4 of my dummy variables side by side next to the ethnic group. And you want to double check to make sure it looks right. So if you have an Hispanic student, you should have 1 under Hispanic and then 0, 0, 0. Because yes, this female, number 55, is Hispanic. She is not black, she is not Asian, and she is not of mixed ancestry. Right here, our black student, not Hispanic. Yes, black, not Asian, not mixed. So she should have a black, number 1 on black and nothing else. The mixed ethnicity, we have yes on mixed, 0, 0, 0. Asian Pacific, yes on Asian, 0, 0, 0, because they're not Hispanic, black, or mixed. You might be thinking, well, what about the white students? How do we know what's going on with them? We'll take a look here. They have 0, 0, 0, 0. So we identify the white students by 4 zeros. Because they're not Hispanic, not black, not Asian, and not of mixed ethnicity. So that's how we can figure out the difference between these 5 groups using only 4 different variables, dummy variables. Okay. So once you've got this, everything looks good, you can actually put them into your regression model. So here's just a straight up multiple regression dialog window here. You need to put all of these dummy variables in. Right, so if you were to, put these in here and turned out one of them was not significant, and then you want to add other variables, don't take any of them out. If you're going to use one of them, you need to use all of them. Otherwise, it's going to change the interpretation. So you put all of them in, and it's very important that you never include the original ethnicity variable. This variable here should never be included in a regression analysis. Why not? Well, the problem is, as you recall, it's coded like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you were to put this into the regression equation, it wouldn't know that these are different groups. It would just look at the numbers, and it would think it's a continuum of ethnicity. So the person of mixed ethnicity has 5 times as much ethnicity as this person. Asians have twice as much ethnicity as Hispanics. It doesn't make any sense at all. It's no good. So that's why this variable should never be included in your regression model. It should only be coded like this and included. So I put a line through to emphasize that. And at that point, you can run the analysis. All right, let's pause here. In the next video, I will show you how to interpret this output in your regression.